The next lecture that we are going to discuss in magnetic circuit is electromechanical energy conversion device. In the first lecture of magnetic circuit, we have discussed what is an electromechanical energy conversion, that the electrical energy will be converted to mechanical energy and mechanical energy will be converted to electrical energy. So when electrical energy is converted to mechanical energy or mechanical energy is converted to electrical energy, then such type of devices are known as electromechanical energy conversion device. So in our case, we will see that electromechanical energy conversion device, the machine can be operate as a motor or a generator. So in the motoring mode, we will see that the electrical energy is converted to mechanical energy, and this principle is known as motoring principle or the motoring device. When the mechanical energy is converted to electrical energy, then the device is known as the generator, and this is known as the generating principle. So either the energy can be converted to from the mechanical to electrical or electrical to mechanical. So both the devices are known as the electromechanical energy conversion device. We know that the electrical power is equal to the product of voltage into current, and the mechanical power is equal to torque into omega, where omega is equal to the speed with which the machine or the shaft is rotated in angular motion. So under the steady state condition, we can see that the electrical power will be equal to the mechanical power. So then it will be in equilibrium stage. So here the electrical power, the product of voltage into current, is converted to the product of torque into omega, which is the mechanical power. Then the electrical energy is converted to mechanical energy. From mechanical to electrical, the torque into omega, which is the mechanical power, is converted to the electrical energy, that is voltage into current. Now we'll see some of the applications of electric motor. So electric motor can be used either in the industries or in the domestic appliances. Industries we use in hammer process, drilling machines, lathe, shapers, blowers, etc. In domestic appliances, we can use it in refrigerators, fans, water pumps, toys and mixers. So similarly, generator will be used in hydroelectric power plant, steam power plant, diesel power plant, nuclear power plant and in automobiles. The function of generator is to generate the electrical energy, and the function of motor is to produce the mechanical power. At this point of time, I would like to say that the DC machine, whenever we say, it is both as a motor or as a generator. Now when we will see the DC machine, we will see that the DC generator has become obsolete nowadays. So we are not using the DC generator. The reason is that it is better to produce electrical energy in AC form and convert to the DC form. That will be more economical. And AC to DC conversion is possible with the help of a device which is known as the rectifiers. When we require the DC to AC conversion, then it is done with the help of an inverters. Okay, so DC generators has become obsolete nowadays. So DC machine, when we say, it is analogous to what we say as DC motors. So DC machine nowadays has become analogous to DC motors, whereas DC generator has become obsolete. Now the same machine can work both as a generating principle or motoring principle. Means if electrical energy is converted to mechanical energy, then the machine will be operating as the motoring principle, whereas the energy when converted from mechanical to electrical form, it is operating as the generator. So we need not to change the machine, rather a same machine with the same construction and working principle will be useful for the energy conversion in one form to another. However, whole of the energy in one form is not converted into another useful form, because some amount of losses will always be there. So most of the input power is converted to useful output power. However, some of the input power is converted to heat loss, that is I square R loss, when you will be having I square R, which is due to the flow of the current in the conductor. Magnetic losses will be there. Magnetic losses is basically the sum of hysteresis loss plus eddy current loss and friction loss. So whenever we will study the transformer, we will see that transformer is a static device, so there will not be any friction loss. However, in any AC-DC machine, we will be having hysteresis and eddy current loss as the magnetic losses and friction loss, and there will be other losses. A small amount of input power is stored in the magnetic field of electromechanical device. Since this electromechanical device is made up of the inductor, which is present in the coil, so a small amount of power will be stored in the magnetic field of the electromechanical device. So electromechanical device is very useful because all of the energy will be transferred either from the electrical to mechanical form or mechanical to electrical form. Thank you.